Howdy folks, welcome to round one here. Gonna take a little bit of pain out of the opener to make sure that if my opponent lightning bolts the Noble Hierarch, I'll still be able to go Inquisition into Shambling Vent on turn two. Ah, Faithless Looting. Looks like Dredge. Yeah, they discarded Double Golgari Grave Troll. Well, that's unfortunate. I guess we can afford to Inquisition at least once. That's a whole lot of explosiveness. I really wanted to get down a Grim Flayer this turn, so that I could actually start pressuring the opponent and potentially find one of the two main deck scavenging uses off of a Grim Flayer hit. But looking at this hand, I think I need to fire off both Inquisitions now while I can still get some value and leave my opponent to slow dredge for a couple of turns. But they're going to be flashing my Faithless Looting soon anyway. Yeah, I'm just going to take the Tormenting Voice, leave them with the Insolent Neonate, which will make them a little bit more explosive. And then I'm going to go with the Grim Flayer plan like I was talking about. I really need to find a scavenging use as soon as possible, or I'm just going to be dead this game. Yeah, game one in this matchup in particular is pretty rough. Not absolutely unwinnable. I mean, no matchup is absolutely unwinnable, but it's definitely not a good one. There's the Dredge, finds Conflagrate, Prized Amalgam, another Golgari Grave Troll. Main deck Collective Brutality is interesting. That card is so good in the Burn matchup. And I think Burn might be one of the few decks in the format that can give Dredge a run for its money in game one, so. The card makes sense. This looks like a Life from the Loam, as opposed to the Insolent Neonate that I was expecting, which is kind of interesting. I think Neonate's better. We know that our opponent has their third land already, and they have plenty of dredge material in their graveyard. Oh, he was conflagrating my board. That makes sense. That makes way more sense. Alright, Inquisition, I guess. Yeah, Conflagrate there is pretty good, because now even if I do find a scavenging use, I'm not going to have enough green mana to activate it in a meaningful way. There's an Archimeba hit, there's a couple of Blood Ghasts. Yeah, this game's over. Well, I can hit specifically Ooze plus Green Source, because we get one draw here off the Mishra's Bauble. I'll give it one more draw step, but not looking good, right? Not looking ideal. Okay. GG close. Both sides played hard. So this is one reason that I really felt the ley lines were necessary. Dredge is pretty popular on Magic Online. Okay, Anafenza stays in. Liliana probably gets cut. Hard to imagine Liliana's going to be good enough. The Last Hope can maybe stay in. We'll see. Murderous Cut's okay. Collective Brutality is not. This amount of discard is kind of iffy. We're down to 58 cards, though. What about Gideon? Should I play Gideon? Just, like, try and end things quickly. Oh, I might want the discard because I'm bringing in ley lines, right? Like, if I can open up with a piece of discard and a ley line, it seems better. Okay, I'm going to cut some decays then. Keep the thought seizes in. Yeah. Explosives is a little loose. You don't really want to plan for after your opponent has a pile of prized amalgams in play, right? Because you're probably losing that game, even if you can deal with the prized amalgams. We still have some removal in the form of Path to Exile and Murderous Cut. We're not off it entirely or anything like that. I think the sideboard plan looks okay. We're mostly just in the Mulligan into Leyline of the Void camp, but I might keep Discard into Scavenging Use as well. We'll see. Hand looks great. We don't have a discard spell to combine with a ley line to make sure that they don't have an answer to it, but you're not mulliganing your opening ley line hand, right? That's kind of why the card is here. I'd really like the ley line to be good enough, because our hand doesn't have a ton of pressure, right? Not a lot going on here. Oh, awesome. Well, that's great, too. Gonna find another green source, probably Temple Garden. Oh, no, it needs to be a black source. It needs to be a black source for Liliana, that's right. Should I just grab a swamp then? Is that fine? It's probably okay. Although if they can clear the Noble Hierarchs, then I am going to be a little mana screwed, right? Kind of a concern. Well, Hierarchs do give me access to white and green. Those exalted triggers. Go into town. Let's run out Goyf here. And then next turn we can go Liliana plus downtick to hopefully pump our Tarmogoyf. Yep, there's Imp. Okay, now we're gonna go Liliana uptick and shrink the Imp, I believe. Oh, interesting. Getting the most value out of our exalted triggers, right? Because if I attack with the Tarmogoyf, then I would just be getting in 3 damage instead of 4. Oh, awesome. That might change things. Probably not, but, you know. Oh, I'd be doing more damage if I went Gideon Emblem attack, because then the Gideon itself would be going to the graveyard and pumping the Tarmogoyf. This is fine. We should be representing lethal next turn regardless. And I can't really think of a series of draws that gets the opponent out of this. He says, jinxing himself. Liliana is kind of close to ultimating. Okay. Yeah, I was deciding whether I wanted to downtick Liliana there before attacking or not. Didn't really matter, clearly. What about Zealous Persecution? Over one of the Lingering Souls, maybe? Yeah, no, this is good. Yeah, I like Gideon. Just a decent amount of pressure when I've got a lot of dead cards to take out. Plays really well with the Lingering Souls and with the Mana Dorks. Okay, so this is the sort of hand where if one of these Tarmogoyfs was a Scavenging Ooze, I'd be tempted. But I'm not. Absolutely not. This would be a great keep in the dark, but we're not in the dark here. So, our decision-making needs to adjust. Opponent's down to 5. I still don't think this is good enough. And then, now that we're on 5, I don't think we go to 4, but maybe we do. Like, they might have an answer to a ley line at this point. That might be what they were looking for. I just don't see this hand beating much of anything, right? We'd have to naturally draw into a Scavenging Ooze, and even then it might not win. Let's go to 4. Do not think we're getting there. Doesn't seem likely. Has not found a conflagrate yet. Interesting, Haunting Dead. Pop this Seer Graveyard out here. Okay, there's Nature's Claim. Yeah, so they might have been mulling aggressively for that, but their hand seems perfectly fine regardless. The lightning axe. Is my Grimflayer gonna get axed a question? It is. Okay. Awkward. They dredge, they find Bloodghast. There's only one prized amalgam. No land drop. Well, they're not trying for the land drop either, which makes me think that Haunted Dead is going to happen. Awkward.
Yeah, Thoughtseize is a little late. Actively bad here. But our opponent was probably just going to, like, discard two cards to the Haunted Dead anyway, so... So they already had infinite discard outlets for with what we're seeing in the hand here. And there's a chance that the Thoughtseize finds a spell hanging out in there. Not a very good chance, but a chance, right? Anyway, our odds of winning this game are well below 5% at this point. That time when you wondered if you should have mulliganed to three cards, if that was the mistake, if there was a mistake. I can't even block, right? I can't attack, I can't block. Yeah, this is creatures you control get +2/+0. And it's a red cost on the flashback. And they found a conflagrate. Although the conflagrate would need a little bit of setting up. They would, because they're currently hellbent, right? So they need to dredge back the life from the loam. Or something along those lines. But rally is... Yeah, just flat creatures you control. Not even just attackers, just flat creatures you control. Yep, so we're dead. in case you were wondering what this means, it means that we are dead. D-E-D, dead. Okay. I can actually just flashback the conflagrate to clear some spirits. I'm only at one, so... GG, well played, opponent. GG, well played. Yeah. So, we played a deck with main deck Scavenging Ooze and some ley lines in the board. Was not good enough. Dredge, still a good deck. Still officially a good deck. Yeah, so hopefully we'll have a little bit better luck next round. See you folks there.